If you are not really sure which of these three Python libraries you could use in your next data pipeline, then this video is for you guys. I will try to explain you briefly and to give you some examples, not to go in too many details because the risk to be confused in the end of the video with too many information is really big. For that reason, agenda for today is to go across per library to represent you some positives, negatives when we could use these libraries and to have the summary in which we will summarize the information and we will know in which scenario which library is good to be used and we could use the benefits, the actual benefits from this library. If you like this video, if you want to be part of our community, don't wait, click on the subscriber button and not to forget to click on bell button too. Actually, all of these libraries we could use and they will work and will progress and transform our data. But in some scenario, we could use really great benefits per library. What I mean, you will see now. Let's start with Pandas. The positives for Pandas is that it's really famous. We have really big community about the Pandas. And if you have any questions, any problems, to could find out them answers, it will be really easy for you guys. It's really easy to be written like a commands. It's how to say, we have a lot of functions that we could use here. But one thing it's really important to know here about the Pandas. Pandas, it's really good for data that it's how to say like a size, it's smaller or equal to a resource that we have on our computer. Why? Because Pandas it's running on single machine on our computer, and if the data it's smaller and or equal to our computer capacity like a memory, then everything it's just fine. It's really nice to be used. About the powers. Powers, it's a library that it's organized and the focus here is to have really good performance. It's really similar to Pandas. It's better with like performance than Pandas. It's not important the sets to be organized and to be engaged with our computer capacity, but the community it's not so big. If you have a problems, a risk to not find out answers of our problems it's really big, and not have too many integrations with another libraries like Pandas. About PySpark. PySpark it's really really nice for large data sets and for big data, and here the key part is that PySpark running on clusters, which mean on group of computers of machines. Pandas and Powers are focused on single machine running, but PySpark is running on cluster, which mean when we run our code we use bunch of computers to progress our data, which makes PySpark really easy to be scaled with the time. Like a functionality, like integration, like a function, like a way of writing, it's really easy and good and so on. But the key difference than Powers and Pandas is that we run the PySpark on cluster. Of computers. Like a summary here, what we could say. Pandas it's really good for small data sets, or to say data sets that are with a memory and size, then it's smaller or equal to our computer. Powers it's really good with small data frames and big data frames too, working really good. But risk for support and help from the world side to say it's not so good like Pandas, and integration that we have with another libraries, it's not so big choices like Pandas, for example. And something else here that it's good to mention too between Pandas especially and Pours, it's that we could run in Pours our process in parallel. To could do that with Pandas, we should use integration with another libraries, which is negatives for Pandas and positive for Pours. Briefly, Pandas for small datasets, it's really, really good. And datasets that are smaller or equal to our computer capacities. For the big datasets, and if we don't want to have this flexibility to scale and to have datasets that are large, then Pours work really good. But if we want large datasets, then it's really much, much better to use PySpark. Why? Because we will not running our code on one single machine. We will running on cluster of machines, and this will make our processing really, really faster for large data sets. I hope this to help you to figure out what is the difference in which scenarios, which of the these Python libraries you could use. If you like this video, click on the like button too. And we'll see you in the next video.